likes of Eugene Laverty and Garrett Gerloff outside of the top 10 positions at the moment, but with promising first sectors at very least as they try to bring themselves to within a second of our current session leader, Alex Lowes. Only 5 minutes remaining in the session. Chas Davies making his way out of the pits now and down towards the pit exit. So he's going to go for one last short stint at the end of the session. Scott Redding likewise. And now we'll find out who's got the pace to finish Friday as fastest.
Yeah, we saw Jonathan Ray's team there just changing out his rear wheels. So for Jonathan Ray, he's certainly going to be going out on a fresh tyre at the end of this session, see what he's able to do with that. Scott Redding, he's down the order in ninth spot. You'd expect him to be out in a fresh tyre for his fourth stint of the session and see if he's able to make a step forward. But we are now starting to see red sectors and orange sectors, personal bests for a lot of riders there in the midfield trying to move up, whether you're looking from Eugene Laverty all the way down to Cara Casulo in 16th spot.
It does appear that mostly they're gaining that ground in the first sector or the first couple of sectors of the lap. We'll see if Laverty can sustain it to the finish, but certainly Gerloff, for example, has dropped off ground as the lap has gone on. He fails to improve in the end of 1 minute 53. Laverty does improve. It's only one position gained, though. He moves above Maximilian Scheibe. Just caught the tail of traffic there with Xavi Forrest directly in front of him on track.
Yeah, and for Laverty, at least he's able to move into the top 10. It'll give him a little bit of confidence, but still enough time for another few laps at the end of this session to see if he's able to move a little bit further up. He only found a couple of hundredths of a second there, but like you said, Alex, enough to give him that extra spot.
Less than 4 minutes remaining on the clock then. As a reminder, from this free practice two, it's Alex Lowes who leads the way with a 1 minute 51 flat ahead of Jonathan Ray and Toprak Razgatlioglu. The fastest times from free practice one earlier on today, significantly faster as Michael Vandermark comes across the line to set a 1 minute 51.548. So that is an improvement on his previous best. He's just over half a second back from the current session leader in free practice two. The top seven closely packed together. Vandermark and Redding somewhat isolated, eighth and ninth, and then a whole pack from 10th position down as things stand. 3 minutes remaining.
Yeah, Vandermark's pace very consistent on this run as well, so that bodes well for the number 60. This is his teammate Toprak Razgatlioglu on the 54. We know Toprak's been able to set a fast time at the start of the session, but struggling a little bit now to be able to set some times, but obviously quite a bit of traffic there around him. Xavi Forres gets out the way.
We've generally seen good consistency from the Yamahas through 2020 so far, but so far this weekend they've looked a little bit at sea compared to the opening few rounds of this campaign, and they've certainly got work to do over the rest of the weekend.
Yeah, certainly taking a little bit more time to get up to speed than I think would have been expected for them, considering they came here for a two-day test. But we have to always be a little bit wary what we see on a Friday. It's not like in some other series where you have to set a fast time in free practice to get yourself through into qualifying two, like what we see in MotoGP, for instance. For these riders, free practice is just that. It's trying to get as much information as possible, learn as much as possible, and then you go into the Super Bowl session, and that's the only time where it matters to be able to go out and set a fast time.
Talking about Yamaha's improving their times, Loris Baz is on to potentially improve. Meanwhile, further up the order, Michael Ruben Rinaldi was up after the first half of the lap. He's dropped a little bit of ground in sector number three, so we'll see what he can do. Baz moves up into 12th position, not the kind of gains that the first half of the lap might have suggested would be in prospect. Rinaldi is very much on to improve. He hasn't dropped a huge amount in that third sector, but the margins are pretty small up towards the top of the field, so we'll see what Rinaldi can do. It's up to the final sector as to whether he can get the job done. He's over the line to improve into fourth position, so it is a new personal best for this session, 151.1, and Scott Redding is also on a much improved lap this time around. He could potentially go up towards the top of the order. We've got problems for Leon Haslam at turn one, and flags are waving into that first turn as Scott Redding makes his way through the final sector of the lap. This is an important moment for Scott Redding to try and finish Friday on a high. It's generally been a challenging weekend for him so far. He's shown some signs of frustration at times as well. Redding comes over the line to move up into second place. A new personal best on his Friday, 1 minute 51 flat, just fractionally slower than Alex Lowes. And Jonathan Ray is also up at the half lap distance.
Yeah, we know Ray's out there on a fresh tyre, so he's trying to make sure he's able to really assert himself in this session with his long run pace and now also a single lap pace. He's up by 0.2 of a second coming down in towards the last corners.
So Alex Lowes leads us from Scott Redding in second, Jonathan Rea is hoping to move past the pair of them. Alex Lowes, after a turn 14 incident, is going to be unable to improve on his time. The checkered flag less than 30 seconds away from falling. It looks as though it's going to be Jonathan Rea who will move provisionally top in this free practice too. If he's hooked it up in the final sector, he has. First rider in FP2 to dip below the 1 minute 51s. It's a 1:50.865 that's the new target time, with the checkered flag about to fall at the end of Friday here in Aragon.
Yeah, Rea with his best times in each sector there as well, so really comes into his own there with the fresh tyre at the end of this session. But obviously these are just the times for free practice too. We haven't seen anyone really make a step towards Chaz Davis's times from this morning session, but good stuff there from Rea to be able to get himself up. Scott Redding's obviously made a bit of a step forward there in the fresh tyre at the end of the session.
Important improvement for Redding as well, because that's faster than he went earlier on today also.
Yeah, and that's exactly what Redding needed to do with that fresh tyre. And on the 45 Ducati, he knows that he needs to make those improvements. He's still down there in eighth position on the combined times, but at least he'll have that bit of momentum behind him now in the hotter track conditions of the afternoon.
So Jonathan Rea from Alex Lowes, from Scott Redding. Redding's not going to be able to make a further improvement on this lap, although it's another decent effort. It's going to be below the 1:52, certainly. It's a 1:51.3 as he crosses the line. So only 0.3 of a second off what he had done on the previous lap. But he now sees the checkered. So it's Rea, Lowes, Redding, Raz Gadlioglu, three of the top four in this session, also setting their fastest times of the day here in Aragon.